this picture here sums up what has plagued the world the last 3 years or so. Flat Earth. Can you recognize Supernatural? I can. It isn't by chance that a billion things are happening right now. And I know a lot of you strong Christians can't see this. Can't see the problem with the comic in front of our faces there. See, I believe different than I did a few years ago. And we can talk about that two-word subject without using those two words. Who is this Dennis the Menace? He says the only words we really need to talk about. And that's why you have those two words in your ear. See little Dennis here, he lives in the same world that I live in now, and it's an important thing to live in this world, and I know some of you can't see it, and it's not, in my understanding, you're not gonna see it yet. You will see it, but it's gonna take something to get you there. But in Genesis, this is how my world was created. Literally, this is how my world was created. In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. And the earth was without form and void. And darkness was upon the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters. And God said, "Let there be light." And there was light. And God saw the light, that it was good. And God divided the light from the darkness. God called the lightness day, and the darkness he called night. And the evening and the morning were the first day. God said, "Let there be a firmament in the midst of the waters, and let it divide the waters from the waters." And God made the firmament and divided the waters which were under the firmament from the waters which were above the firmament, and it was so. And God called the firmament heaven, and the evening and the morning were the second day. That's Genesis 1 through 8, chapter 1, verses 1 through 8. And that's where I live. See, in the firmament holds those waters so that we can have earth. Because those waters, we don't really know what those waters are, I don't think. The great deep. That's heaven. So I don't really know about space, guys. That's a problem. If you're gonna believe in some place you're never going, first of all, that should be something that you consider. And then you've been paying for it dearly your whole life, pretty much. All for a endeavor that, if we really think about it, it's total blasphemy. Look at what little Dennis is saying. If you think that way, you've got that abiding in you. You've got this Genesis abiding in you. 1 John chapter 1 says, "That which was from the beginning, which we have heard, which we have seen with our eyes, which we have looked upon, and our hands have handled, of the word of life. For life was manifested, and we have seen it, and bear witness, and show unto you that eternal life which was with the Father was manifested unto us. That which we have seen and heard declare we unto you, that ye also may have fellowship with us, and truly our fellowship is with the Father and with his Son Jesus Christ. And these things write we unto you, that your joy may be full. And then 1 John chapter 2, verses 24 through 27 says, let that therefore abide in you, which ye have heard from the beginning. If that which ye have heard from the beginning shall remain in you, ye also shall continue in the Son and in the Father. And this is the promise that he hath promised us, even eternal life. These things I have written unto you concerning them that seduce you. But the anointing which ye have received from him abideth in you, and ye need not that any man teach you. But as the same anointing teacheth you of all things, and is truth, and is no lie, and even as it hath taught you, ye shall abide in him. Our world's been seduced, guys. We've fallen for it. In the book of Revelation, the first three chapters, Jesus is telling John what to write, and he's writing letters to seven churches, and their instruction for the body of Christ. And in chapter 2, I'll just read them, verses 20 through 22. Notwithstanding, I have a few things against thee, because thou sufferest that woman Jezebel, which calleth herself a prophetess, to teach and to seduce my servants to commit fornication and to eat things sacrificed unto idols. And I gave her space to repent of her fornication, and she repented not. Behold, I will cast her into a bed, and them that commit adultery with her into great tribulation, except they repent of their deeds. Then in Revelation chapter 3, to the angel of the church in Sardis, verse 3, he says, remember therefore thou hast received and heard, and hold fast and repent. If therefore thou shalt not watch, I will come on thee as a thief, and thou shalt not know what hour I come upon thee. Romans 1:18 says, for the wrath of God is revealed from heaven against all ungodliness and unrighteousness of men who hold the truth in unrighteousness. Holding the truth, it's being hidden from us. Verse 19, because that which may be known of God is manifest in them, for God hath showed it unto them. Verse 20, for the invisible things from him from the creation of the world are clearly seen, being understood by the things that are made, even his eternal power and Godhead, so that they are without excuse. Because that when they knew God, they glorified him not as God, neither were thankful, but became vain in their imaginations, and foolish, and their foolish hearts was darkened. Professing themselves to be wise, they became fools. And that's right where we are, guys. We've become fools. Then in Matthew 24, Jesus was telling his disciples what would be the sign of the end of the world, because they asked him, they were in private, and they were up on the Mount of Olives. And he said, in verse 14, he said, and this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world for a witness unto all nations, and then shall the end come. I think we know possibly what he was talking about there, guys, I think we have a gospel of the kingdom being preached in all the world as a witness right now. So we could even just call it that. We don't need to use those two words. Isaiah chapter 42, verse 6. I, the Lord, have called thee in righteousness, and will hold thine hand, and will keep thee, and give thee for a covenant of the people, for a light of the Gentiles, to open blind eyes, to bring out the prisoners from the prison, and them that sit in darkness out of the prison. I am the Lord, that is my name, and my glory will I not give to another, neither my praise to graven images. Behold, the former things are come to pass, and new things do I declare. Before they spring forth, I tell you of them. Sing unto the Lord a new song, and his praise from the end of the earth, ye that go down to the sea, and all that is therein, the isles and the inhabitants thereof. And I'll just end this transmission with this verse in chapter 42 of Isaiah, verse 23. Who among you will give ear to this? Who will hearken and hear for the time to come? In the world ye shall have tribulation, but be of good cheer. Jesus overcame the world. We can too.